So that's the favourite we're talking about for the women's 100 butterfly, Dana Vollmer.
She's now a spokeswoman for the American Heart Association for their Go Red for Women awareness campaign. She's well now. There is no more signs of any heart condition.
And in lane four here, so has the Premier lane. So it's a great lineup. We've got the Briton one and the second American in two. The Dane, who's a world champion in the 100 freestyle in three. And then Vollmer, then Coots, Olympic gold medalist from here. The world record holders in lane six. And then China and Italy.
We can't dismiss Sarah Sjostrom in lane number six. She's had some good form this year. Very good in the 200 freestyle as well as the 100 butterfly. But all indications are the American champion is the one that's really on song here.
And she broke the Olympic record in the heat and then wasn't far off that. In fact, it was interesting. She went out slower in the heat. She was actually quicker in the semi-final and came home a little slower. So I just wonder how she'll go out tonight, Vollmer.
The touch wasn't quite as good in the semi-final as it was in the heat. And off memory, she was quite close to that world record in the semi-final, but just didn't hit the wall quite as well. And it comes down to just that when you're so close to the world record.
And she did 56.25 in the heat and 56.36 in the semi, so not much between those.
I think the excitement of a final, she will go out quite fast.
So the first of the finals, about to get underway. Here's the introduction. She's a tall girl, isn't she, Ellen Gandy? And she was fifth of the World Championships last year.
She's a huge talent, trains in Melbourne in Australia with Rowan Taylor. Her father was relocated there for work when she was young.
So Claire Donoghue, personal best in the semi-final.
Studied social work at Western Kentucky University.
Here's Jeanette Otterson, who set a national record in the semi-final. And as we said, she has won a 100-metre freestyle at the World Championships.
Showing her versatility. She's also another tall girl. And that's the Danish saying or motto, every second counts for these Olympic Games.
Now here's the woman who's centre of attention, the favourite Dana Vollmer. You talked about her remarkable story a moment ago.
She's married to a fellow swimmer, Andy Grant. He's here, her husband. NC2A Swimmer of the Year in 2009.
So Alicia Coots, such a big part in Australia's win last night in the 4x100 freestyle. So a gold medal already here.
She's had a remarkable 2 years for Australia. Five gold medals at the Commonwealth Games. Silvers at the World Championships last year.
World record holder, only teenager in the field, youngest woman in the final, and she's the world record holder.
And she won a world championship way back in 2009.
And third behind Vollmer last year at the world titles was Liu Ying of China.
China's only won the gold in this on one occasion in 1992.
They were strong in Barcelona, weren't they?
They were.
And Ilaria Bianchi of Italy, she produced a best time ever for her in the semi-final to make it through. So that's the form.
Ladies and gentlemen,
Vollmer in four, Coots five, Otterson three, the world record holder in six. I think the world record's under threat here.
I believe it is too. Americans have won this race on five occasions in Olympic history.
We've got to go back to Amy Van Dyken in Atlanta in 1996, the last time they won it. It's been dominated a bit by the Australians in the last two Olympics.
Alicia Coots looking to continue that. Lots of focus from the girls.
So that's the lineup for the final of the women's 100-metre butterfly. On the blocks. Almost set. The favourite in lane four.
Take your mark.
And it looked to be a clean start. How fast will Vollmer be early? Is she first up? Not quite. I reckon Otterson was first up in lane three. Liu Ying was away quickly also in lane number seven.
Liu Ying had the fastest reaction time, also the fastest start. She's in lane seven. That is a beautiful start. But already Dana Vollmer in the centre of the pool is going out. Otterson going with her in lane number three as well.
So who gets the split first and how fast will it be? It's inside world record. Otterson leads, Donoghue and Vollmer. The Americans are there ready to strike.
Not just underworld record split, 0.66 underworld record. Fantastic underwater by Dana Vollmer.
She has a narrow lead. Yuling is certainly in the mix, though, in lane seven. Now, how strong can Vollmer be at the end? She's kicked right away. Coots is starting to come home hard. Look at the time. She's well inside the world record. It's 56.06. Vollmer, what a story. It's going to be very close for the world record. Does she get it? She has. She's inside 56 seconds. Remarkable.
What an amazing swim. 55.98, the first woman to go under the 56-second mark. Dana Vollmer, you are a star. Lou getting into second.
And third to Coots of Australia, but it was a dominating performance.
That last 25 metres, she was with the field at the 50. She had a very good underwater off the wall, but the last 25 metres... not a lot in it. It was Lou from China off the start. Very, very convincing. We're travelling with Dana Vollmer. She has a beautiful technique. The arms don't come out too far off the surface of the water. The face is really close to the water surface. There she is now. There's Lou in the bottom of the screen. She was still right up there off the turn. But Dana Vollmer, she was so brilliant. Not a great touch. And it would have been quicker had she been on a full stroke. But you'll take that any day. Olympic Games gold medal, a world record, and the first woman under 56.
Well, it's been a big journey for her, hasn't it? Culminating here in London, Dana Vollmer in a new world record of 55.98, breaking through that 56-second barrier. Liu Ying for China, 56.87. Alicia Coots, 56.94. The world record holder, the former world record holder in fourth place. Bianchi's had a good swim, and then Otterson, Donoghue and Gandy. So the big names in terms of the countries, USA, China and Australia. And look, talked about that journey, Nicole. You talked about what she's been through over the last 8 years. A gold medalist, by the way, back in Athens in the relay, and then all the other things that have happened to her.
It's an amazing story.